Under the estates, stars, and sparkle of Los Angeles, there's another world, and it belongs to these folks.
We're moving about 500 million gallons of sewage a day. I'm Kent Carlson, and I love sewers. Flat out simple.
This team is one of the best in the biz for scrubbing out the unmentionables.
We have approximately 6,500 miles of sewers. The three major obstacles that we find when cleaning the sewers are root intrusion, grease deposits, and debris. You'd be surprised at some of the crap that we find down in the sewers. Toys, vermin, you name it, we've seen it.
They're the unsung heroes of the subterranean, and they're doing what used to be an incredibly dirty job.
You can't believe our sewer excitement when we excavated a sewer and found that this actual pipe that was down there that was actually laid in 1883. And it's the same pipe that we're using today. 26 years ago, when I started with the city of LA, you know, we used very archaic type tools to clean just this type of pipe. You cannot imagine how disgusting it used to be sitting at the bottom of a sewer on a three-legged stool, pushing these rods and scraping that poop back into a bucket to be hauled up to the top while it's dripping all over you.
Today, high pressure tools and robotics have taken the ick out of sewer maintenance, starting with basic cleaning.
So this is the latest in sewer technology that we're using today. Now it's got two sets of nozzles. One is running about 90 degrees to the pipe, which really gives us a super descaling cleaning. The other nozzle is running about 20 degrees, which helps push the crud that we find in the sewers back down the pipe. So we get cleaning going up and cleaning coming back down.
A welcome change from the stick and bucket method.
Now, when we find an anomaly in our sewer, we break out these bad boys right here. The cameras are our eyes into the sewer. They pan and tilt, go up and down. They have LED lighting, and they also have a zoom in too. One of the neat things about this is that we can actually target exactly what's wrong with the sewer.
Kent is the MacGyver of the sewer crowd. When he can't find the right tool for the job, he invents it himself.
A lot of times we do develop our own tools or modify tools. I just draw the blueprints and make the prototype and test it out and hone it till it works just right. We always say we want the best bang for the water drop because water is so precious. This tool right here, we call the rat rod. The older equipment that is still being utilized today is designed to cut that clay pipe and that cast iron and is not very effective in cutting plastic.
So Kent created a cutting pan from a saw blade and mounted it on a lightweight frame. It was perfect for cutting PVC pipes shoved too far into the sewer system.
Before, where it used to take a week and a half to cut the street and dig it up to remove a pipe that was installed correctly, our tools now that we've developed will cut them out in under 5 minutes. Nice.
A growing problem has to do with the lack of rain.
We're now in the middle of a drought in Southern California. We've been finding that trees are pushing more and more roots into the city sewers. I developed an aggregate tool to grind the roots and kind of shear them off at the wall. We're going to test this concept for the very first time today. We'll just run it at 2000 PSI, but at a very slow rate.
This tool will pull double duty, cutting out roots, but also using the stone or aggregate on the outside to scour tough Klingons from the pipes. For the first test, they start with something easy.
As you see, the aggregate did cut. It's following the periphery of the pipe, and we had a successful test. Now what we're gonna try is a larger diameter piece of maple. Okay, here we go.
They've never tried anything like this before.
I just have to roll over in my head everything that can happen or will happen, so then that way I can prepare for it. As you can see, this board is 100 times harder than a root that you would find inside of a sewer.
The tool not only made a good dent in the toughened hardwood, it proved itself a sturdy scrubber.
The aggregate is still structurally sound. And then, although we do have some residual of the pipe in here, which is an indicator that it would probably work very, very well in grinding out cement or concrete Well, it looks like we got a new piece of equipment that's gonna like cut all the mierda out of the freaking pipe. How's that, buddy? With some of the tools that we've developed, we've saved the city over $2 million at least in contractor fees and digging up the street. Your flush is our rush, and we try to keep that sewer flowing as best as possible.